Back now at 7:50, and I suspect you may not know our next guest's name, but you certainly know his face, because he is considered by most one of the best stand-up comics around. He is Jay Leno, and he has gone by such titles as the King of the Club Comics, the Springsteen of comedy for your marathon sessions.
Yeah. I don't know where that came from. I'm not from New Jersey, and I'm not on fire, so that's... But it's nice.
You like playing the club circus.
I like playing the clubs. I like the clubs a lot.
Why? What's it do for you? I mean, why that medium particularly?
Well, because then you find out right away if something's funny. You know, if you're playing the next door neighbor on Who's Got the Butter or some silly sitcom, you never really know if something is funny. You wait 8 weeks and then... Whereas this, you go out, you think of a joke that afternoon, you go out, you try it. If it works, boom.
Yeah, but if it doesn't, rejection.
No, but it's not real. It's not that bad. I mean, if it doesn't work, you move on to the next joke. I mean, you don't break in 20 minutes at a time. You break in just little tiny jokes at a time. If that one works, you know.
You play 100 clubs a year. You must, I mean, you must go beyond New York, Chicago, L.A., Dallas. I mean, you must get out.
I go beyond Biloxi.
Yeah. What are some of the worst?
Don't name the club. You know,
club.
I worked a lot of strange. I'll tell you a real strange one I did about a year ago in Charleston, West Virginia, which is a big mining town, and it was a guy decided to turn a delicatessen into a comedy club. And first of all, you work, it's a coal town, so all you first thing you hear just the audience is that you know, that kind of not coughing, that that kind of thing. But the thing was, the guy had a delicatessen that he put a stage in, and the stupid thing about it, this is absolutely true, everyone sat in booths, so everyone watched you like this. You know, like, you know, they would sit like this through booths and watch the show. And that's how they would look. I would just see eyes looking over the top, and I'd see heads move and laugh. But that's, I mean, it's very, so there's a lot of strange places out there.
Do you find the humor varies? I mean, from place to place? I mean, obviously, you're not going to do coal mining jokes in Los
Angeles.
Actually,
not really. You know what it is? I think a mistake a lot of comedians make, especially New York and Los Angeles comedians. New York comedians, they'll go to, like, West Virginia, and they'll do 10 minutes on the D train in Central Park, and they come back and they go, the people aren't very hip. I mean, everybody has cable now. I mean, you walk into the Deep South and people going, hey, I hear you got a two-pilot deal with a commitment. You know, I mean, everyone watches, you know, these entertainment things. And I mean, everybody gets Newsweek and Time and cable, so everybody kind of knows what's going on. So it's a lot more generic than it used to be.
Mm-hmm.
But obviously, you go into a town, you find out some local thing, some local politician, a local place, and you...
You give me a natural segue. I hear you got a multi-spot deal with NBC's Blooper Show.
I am doing some things with Bloopers
and Practical
Jokes.
Funny we should talk about that.
Yes, yes, it's kind of odd.
What are you going to be doing for them?
Oh, I'll just do some funny films, take a camera out and do some things. I did one last week. It'll be on in a few months. Garage sales, you know, things you find at garage sales, which are very...
I haven't seen this either. Let's take a look at one of the kinds of things you'll be doing.
Do we have one?
Yeah.
I didn't even know we had one.
Let's roll it.
You go through an x-ray machine, they open your bags, they go through all your luggage, and you get on the plane, you sit down and eat, they give everybody steak knives. Hey, if I bring my own steak knife, I get 20 years in jail.
Ma'am?
Now your job is to watch the screen and if anything suspicious shows up.
That's right.
Now, do you ever turn on Days of Our Lives or anything like that?
No.
Any sign of your luggage yet, sir?
One piece missing.
One piece? How many have you gotten so far?
One out of two, ain't
there? One out of two. You want to keep the one bag you have and go home, or you're going to go for the two?
I think we'll have to go for all of them.
Do you find something funny in everything you look at?
Yeah, hopefully. I mean, that's what you try to do. I mean, obviously, not at everything, but...
I mean, like, you look at TVs, movies, stuff like
that. TVs, movies, a lot of funny things. What I see on the plane coming in, I saw Rambo 2.
It's already on the plane.
Yeah, it is on the plane, which is kind of interesting. See, I would like to see Stallone combine the Rocky and the Rambo films. Just literally come out and beat himself to death. It'd be kind of interesting. But you know what, you know what I thought was interesting? I love it when other countries get very self-righteous, like... this is a story, you were talking about it. The English want to ban Rambo as obscene because they feel the movie condones American-style violence. Mm-hmm. What I think Stallone should do is maybe go back and reshoot some of the scenes in a soccer uniform, make it a little easier for these people to understand.
I think I better leave that one alone.
Oh, that's a good joke.
No, that's a good joke.
A little too hard-hitting for this time of the morning?
A little touchy. it's a little
You know, see, that's
touchy.
What's great. You know, that's what's great. I was on the Letterman show a couple weeks ago. I did 10 minutes on Reagan. Everyone laughed. I did a joke about Barry Manilow, and the crowd went, ooh. But I just like the fact that Stallone and Barry Manilow, people, ooh, leave that alone.
Give me a Reagan
joke.
You can
make fun of the president if you want. What was the joke I was doing about a Reagan joke?
You know, Ronald Reagan, president.
Ronald Reagan. Well, just today they said that over the weekend he was going to meet with some of his senior advisors. I mean, this guy's 74. I mean, the whole country's only 200. We got a couple of guys from the Bull Moose Party down there. You know, good heavens.
It is said that you don't look at the clubs as a means to a greater end, that you just like the clubs. How long can you stay contented doing?
Well, see, that's the great thing about comedy. It's the Peter principle taken. People, a lot of friends of mine, they do the Tonight Show and then they go home and they want to direct. You know, I mean, that's, it's true. I mean, I'm finally at the point now where you can fill up a major club on a Wednesday at 11 o'clock and people go, gee, why don't you do something else? Why don't you change? And to me, Cosby's got the ideal career. Because he's a comedian. He's doing a TV show now, fine. Commercial, fine. But he always comes back and does his act.
We're glad you made room for us. Thanks.
Well, thank you.
Good luck.
I appreciate it.
We'll come back after these messages.